chocolate connoisseur, somebody who is looking for something that will satiate your palate. So you're not constantly going back and forth for another piece. You can actually introduce one piece, have it penetrate in a way where you're completely satisfied, but you definitely want to dip into a little bit more.
So what would you say is the literally the best chocolate out of all of this to have with wine? Just in general. I know it's hard to say. But
it is very difficult to say. In fact, that's the reason why there's so many variations, because we're dealing with a situation where everybody's palate is completely different. When you go wine tasting, you're going to have somebody to your left who will taste something different than the person to your right. And you are that third flavor profile. So some people enjoy the tannin qualities, the acidic qualities. Some people want a really balanced, mellow wine. Some people like something with a lot of fruit-forward flavor to it. Some people like something that's very dry but still has a lot of character to it. So by putting your finger on one chocolate to pair with all these different wines is absolutely possible.
So those are that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wow.
Ooh, totally balances it out completely.
So it still changes the flavor profile.
Right? Oh, yeah.
When we're trying to cut a little bit of the sweetness down,
mm-hmm.
Add something to your palate that is complementary. Even though there's a really contrasting flavors, we're talking about a dry, rich, robust 91%, which a 91% most people wouldn't even attempt to eat because of that bitter quality.
Yeah.
It's still pretty intense, but it doesn't have that characteristic that's off-putting. It has a pink Murray River salt on it, which is a pyramid gourmet flake. It's got a touch of a pink hue to it. It's a very delicate sea salt. It hits the palate and leaves the palate.
And you were talking a lot about salts. Tell us a little bit more about that.
So sea salt. Going through culinary school, I noticed that was one of my best qualities was, as a student, I knew how to season properly. And having the height that I had, I realized that if I seasoned my food from a distance, it actually fell to my food in a very...
Like snow?
Exactly. Very even path.
Yeah, yeah.
And I think that was the distinguishing factor. You have to think of it in a way to where you need to coat the ingredient evenly so that each bite tastes the same. Mm-hmm. And you want to draw all those flavors. Then I had a chef pull me aside, but she said, "You're getting ready to work for the chef. What do you know about salt?" And at the time, being a student, there's table salt, there's sea salt, there's kosher salt, and it ultimately came down to there's more variations of gourmet salt than there are mushrooms on the planet. Chocolate, in my opinion, is the focal point, is the one ingredient I wanted to work with. So by trying to find the right sea salt to add to the chocolate, what we're doing is we're drawing out the flavors of the chocolate, but at the same time, we're introducing a little bit of salt to your palate, so when you taste the wine, these flavors kind of explode.
Some of the salts that I use are an English sea salt from the Essex Coast called Nala, Pyramid Gourmet Flake from Australia called the Pink Murray River Salt. I love the Pacific Northwest Snowflake Sea Salt.
The flakes are, you know, when you break a Christmas ornament, and the glass ones, and the glass is very, very thin. That's exactly what it reminds me of. It's little tiny chips of Christmas ornament glass. And it's so thin, it's so delicate. And when it hits your palate, it hits and leaves. But it adds so much flavor to the food that you're working with.
Because I know it's really, you know, be healthy for you. If I'm a customer and I'm looking for really quality chocolate, what am I looking for?
It all comes down to taste. It all comes down to what you feel is the most appropriate. So we allow everyone a piece of chocolate to come in and taste all 11 varieties of chocolate. So some people who don't appreciate a darker chocolate, we start them off with the espresso. And because it is still a bittersweet chocolate, that salt kind of curbs the bitterness of the chocolate and smooths it out. Because we don't deal in milk chocolate, we don't deal in white chocolate, we only deal in a bittersweet, which keeps us away from food allergens. So even the baked Cioccolato has got just spices and seasonings in it to mimic the flavor of bacon on the palate. There's no extra important in the product. So it all comes down to the introduction of a little bit of sea salt. And I believe that's the key ingredient here is the salt. The chocolate is the medium.
Fantastic. Well, thanks, Chef. Pretty amazing.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Cheers.